Hey everybody, happy Wednesday. It is I, your songwriting partner, your co-producer, and as always, your friend, Joe Seeby. And happy Wednesday, you guys. And Wednesday is part of our creative writing series that we like to call ghostwriting. Ghostwriting is when we take a famous or, you know, a popular Billboard charted song that's out on the radio right now or out on the charts right now. And our goal in this exercise is to replace all the lyrics of the chorus of that song with our own lyrics. You're probably thinking, why do we do that? Why would you do that? Well, there's a lot of reasons. One, it's a great exercise for your mind. Number two, you're writing a chorus that you could use for yourself later. You know, you just change the melody and change the tempo and you got a set of words right there for something new for yourself. Number three, it forces you to be creative in a short amount of time. You know, let's say there's four short lines for the chorus. Your words got to make complete sense, tell a story, and rhyme in that short amount of time. The hook doesn't have to be long to be good. And if you're one of those people that like write longer hooks or whatever, it's a great exercise for you. You pick a song with a shorter hook and you get to writing. One of the other things I like to do, I call it the first verse curse. Okay, so as a songwriter myself and you guys, if you're like me, I'll write all my best stuff in my first verse. And then when I get to chapter two, which is verse two, I always say, all right, and what am I going to say now? I said, oh, everything I really wanted to say in the first verse, what do I write about in chapter two, right? So even though we're writing a chorus here, it's still similar because you have to write this great thing, right? The other object too is like, let's say in their song, they have a three-syllable word, tomorrow, okay? The first line in their hook in their chorus is a three-syllable word. I would prefer that your chorus starts and stops exactly where theirs does, okay? That doesn't necessarily mean if they have a three-syllable word, you need a three-syllable word. If you had three one-syllable words, if they fall into the pocket of the cadence, then that's fine. As long as, like I said, as long as you start singing and you stop singing exactly when they do. That's really all that matters. It's got to start and stop when they do. It's got to rhyme, of course. It's got to tell a great story. Okay, so the object, again, is to replace all the words out of a famous Billboard charted song. Get rid of all their lyrics and replace their lyrics with your own lyrics, okay? Melody's gotta be the same. Everything's gotta be the same, except it's the words. So, now this exercise is not something that you can do while you're multitasking, okay? This is something that I want you to do. I want you to go in a room by yourself, shut the door, listen to the song that I give you, the assignment song. Listen to it about three or four times. Then, take your notepad like this with line paper, and I'd like you to write out their chorus. Write it top line, write their first line, leave some space underneath, and then put your line underneath. Same thing with all of it, so that you are looking at every word as a section, its own little section. This is why if they have like a three-syllable word, it's if you can come up with a three-syllable word, great. If you can just put, if you want to put three one-syllable words, as long as it works in that spot, have at it. That's the only kind of stipulation or rule in here. One of them. The other one is, of course, it's got to be a great story. And it's got to stop and start exactly what theirs does. Okay, so the song that we're looking at tonight for the emulation, or to replace the lyrics with your own lyrics, is Justin Bieber's song called Anyone. There's not a lot of words in the song, but, well, and that's the good thing, because you got to say kind of a bold statement in short amounts of time, okay? So What I'm going to do right now is I'm going to play you, I'm going to play you Justin Bieber's, you know, I'm going to play you his chorus, and then I'm going to, you know, say the words after you hear the chorus. So here is Justin Bieber's Anyone. So here it is. You know that you are the only one I'll ever love. Yeah, you, if it's not you, it's not anyone. Looking back on my life, you're the only good I've ever done. Yeah. Okay, so you heard the lyrics. Okay, so now we are. I'm gonna go to the lyrics, and I'll read them almost like they're a poem. Okay, so you can really get the gist of it. Okay, so okay, so here it is. His lyrics are. Yeah, that you are the only one I'll ever love. Yeah, you, if it's not you, it's not anyone. Looking back on my life, you're the only good I've ever done. Yeah, you, if it's not you, it's not anyone. Not anyone. So that's Justin's lyrics. Okay. So, what I wrote is, so his first line again is, you are the only one I'll ever love. So I wrote, I will be waiting here till you come home. So I'll read you mine now, like it's a poem. Okay. So I wrote, I will be waiting here till you come home, 'cause I'll still be standing on the path you've roamed. Changing from day to night, it's the light that melts this heart of stone. 'Cause I will be waiting here till you come home. Till you come home. So, and again, you see what I did there? I wrote Justin's words, and then I put mine right underneath. So you can see how I do that, right? So that's how I'd like you guys to try to arrange your words. So write down very clearly and legibly, you know, giving space between each word so that right underneath you can put your words underneath so you can see it. You know, and like I said, this is not an easy assignment. It's going to take you, you know, several tries. This took me hours just to get what I have right now. It took me hours, literally. I rewrote some parts I didn't like, and I thought, you know, and I went back and I rewrote it. So this is not something you can just do in 12 minutes. You know, this is, even though the video is like 12, 15 minutes, it's going to take you a lot longer in real time to do this, okay? So now I'm going to show you, I'm going to play my, I found a karaoke track for the song, so I'm going to do that for you right now, so hold on. Guys. out. All right, guys, that's it. I can't wait to see what you wrote for this chorus. Anyway, this is your songwriting partner, your co-producer, and as always, your friend Joe CB signing off. Have a lovely rest of your evening. Sleep well, sweet dreams, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Peace.